Hi, hello, I'm Bon Bon.
Nice to meet you.
And we're gonna step up to the plate, Edward Cullen. You're up. First and foremost, I have a very love-hate relationship with Edward. He is an absolute wet towel. He is a drag. He is not someone that I would actually want to hang out with in real life because he is very not my style of person to just give energy to over and over again. He's mopey. He's very. If Eeyore was a vampire, he's not fun. He can probably walk into a room and suck the joy out of it like a Dementor. He just, the gloom and doom and the brooding and the, oh, everything is so bad. All right. That said, I'm still Team Edward. I know. I know, you're like, how can you think all of that about this character and still be Team Edward? Let me explain. I'm Team Vampire at this point. I'm still very much waiting for my rich vampire husband to find me and give me all the things that I deserve in life. Moving on. Somebody, I would have done all the things Bella did for him. We're gonna start out with Twilight. Now, okay, just like in the Jacob one, I'm going to be meshing book Edward with movie Edward and Midnight Sun Edward. Because all of them just live in my head, they're sharing space, and it's hard for me to distinguish all of them at this point. Okay. Reading Midnight Sun was not fun. Being inside Edward's head is very emotionally taxing, especially when you yourself are not in that space that he is. It took me the better part of an entire year to read. I got Midnight Sun, I think at the beginning of 2020 when it first came out, I ordered it, got it, started reading it. I had to put it down for several weeks, pick it back up, put it down. That lasted all the way until I think about December, maybe January-ish of 2021, I finished. It took me a long time because I had to like prepare myself. I had to be like, we're gonna read Midnight Sun. We're gonna just get as far as you can, girl. Yep. We're gonna dive in and we're gonna try to finish this thing. I had to pep talk myself to finish this book because Edward is such a drag that, and I knew he would be. I knew he would be. I read it because, loyal to the series. I have to have it as part of my collection. I have to have the books so that my library shelf is complete. Edward is a tragedy. Okay, so when we meet Edward, or when Bella meets Edward, he's not like super personable, right? When they're sitting at the table and she's talking to Jessica and she's like, oh, who them over there? And Jessica does her whole little thing and introduces all of the Cullens and stuff, and then he's sitting over there at the table and he's looking at her like, and we know it's because he can't read her mind, he can't hear her voice, so we know that he's just like, what the hell's going on with that? Why can't I hear this girl? What is it? What's about her? But to Bella, she don't know that. So all she knows is there's some dude over there eyeballing her. For me, that's my cue to just not. That's my cue to just not. But Bella was like, yeah, that's for me. Moving on. was it science class? Biology. She gets to biology. As soon as she hits the door, the fan hit her hair, is waving like that. Edward immediately. And you know, Bella, she was a little self-conscious. She sat down and she was like, Me? I'm in tears. If I have to go sit next to him, I'm angling and I'm just over here like trying not to have a breakdown in class, because apparently the way that I smell to this dude is so egregious that he's gonna jump and act like that. Whole time in class, he's sitting there looking at her like, I'm uncomfortable. Then bell rings, he jump up, run out the classroom. I'm going home. This isn't about Bella. All right, so anyway, Edward at this point tells us in Midnight Sun that the second that he smelled her, her blood smelled so good that he immediately started making plans. He was like, I'm gonna run up, I'm gonna shut the door, lock it, I'm gonna twist the teacher's neck, I'm gonna make my rounds and get all these other students up out of here. Bah, that 10 seconds, not enough time for people to scream, let alone even understand what's going on. Then Bella's on mine. I don't know if I'm a drinker in the classroom or if I'm gonna pop out one of these windows, run into the forest, and then feast. Whole time, he's making plans about what can I do to lure this girl so that I can drain her and not have any witnesses. Am I gonna have to kill all 20 of these students in this room? Or can I convince her to leave with me after class and get my drink on? It was a mess. I'm not gonna lie to you though, that part of Midnight Sun was interesting to read. I was like, oh, yikes, damn. Y'all almost got right in that moment. Y'all don't even know. Y'all know. He didn't do that. You know, so kudos to him. And he tries to get Swish out of the class. Doesn't work. Okay, so anyway, we skip to Alice didn't see that possible situation about to happen. They were about to have a whole ordeal. She didn't see it happen. Why? Because the story has to happen, of course. Why she didn't see it is because she was too busy watching Jasper to make sure that he did not do the same thing. Okay, we get home. And by we get home, I mean like we're Edward right now. So we get home to the other Cullens. And I don't remember if this is the class. Oh yeah, it is. Okay, so he runs off. He goes to Alaska and he lays in the snow. And he lays in the snow for like 2 days or something like that. And he's just laying out there and the snow's like falling on him and it's starting to cover him. And then, you know, his skin is so pale and so white and so paper-like and da-da-da-da-da. Stephanie Meyer like really had a thing about describing how white their skin is. It was very... So anyway, he's out there getting snowed on and Tanya, I don't know, looked out her window and she was like, damn, that lump looks like Edward. So she runs out there and she was like, hey, Eddie, what you doing? And he's like, oh, you know, just lying here lamenting life. I can't believe I've been so unlucky to find somebody so beautiful as her. And all I want to do is drain her blood and was it Tanya or Kate? One of them girls. They were like, okay, well, I'm gonna punch it back home. Hope everything works out. Edward goes home. And that van comes sliding towards Bella, right? And he stops it. He's like, no, you will not crush the love of my life. and saves her, which pisses the family off. They were like, yo, you finna out us as being different. As if, you know, the whole dating your siblings and having golden eyes and talking to nobody in this school, despite the fact that you're trying to blend in, hasn't already tipped people off that you're different. Okay. Edward talks to Alice and she's like, hey, listen, this girl, Bella, two things. You're either gonna drain her or she's gonna become a vampire. And he's like, yeah, I can't accept either of those things. I need a third option. And she was like, guess what, buddy? There's no third option. And he was like, there has to be a third option. Make a third option. And she was like, oh, I see a third option. The third option is you leave and she turns into a husk. Okay. Anyway, moving on. Edward was very unable to accept any of these now three options. And he was like, there has to be something else. There was nothing else. But Edward cannot wrap his head around the fact that this girl, Bella, is now, because, okay, so we're moving forward in time and they're starting to talk and stuff. And then as much as he's telling her, don't be friends with me, don't be friends with me, I'm dangerous, I'm not the good guy, he won't like leave her alone either. Okay, so he's like constantly walking beside her in her ear talking about, hey, Bella, I'm the bad guy. Don't talk to me. Don't be friends with me. I'm dangerous. But also, what are you having for lunch today? We should hang out sometime. Tell me all about you. What's it like being a human? I mean, what's it like living in Arizona? What's your mom like? Tell me everything about you. When I mean everything, I actually mean everything. I'm obsessed with you. So all that, and he doesn't want to accept the fact that all of that nonsense is making this girl that he can't hear fall in love with him. It's like he's playing hard to get and he doesn't realize it. And he's just like, I'm a bad guy. Leave me alone. Don't actually leave me alone. Yes. No. Chase me. Leave me alone. So Bella's getting whiplash. And she's like, I don't know if this dude actually like wants to be cool or not. And he's like, yes, yes, I do. Oh my God. Yes, please. I want to be cool with you. Please don't ever leave me. But also go away. Why am I Team Edward again? Okay. Anyway. He starts sneaking into her room to watch her sleep. And his family tells him, hey, Edward? We're worried about you. This is weird. You're trespassing. You're breaking into this girl's house, into her bedroom at night while she's sleeping. And we just think that you shouldn't do that.
So you shouldn't do that.
We think it's Katsuma. Katsuma. No. X. And Edward was like, no, I have to, it's cool, guys, it's cool. I have to do this because there could be a spider in her room, a poisonous one, and it might bite her in her sleep and she passes away and I won't be able to take that. So I have to be there to make sure that there's no like black widows or banana spiders hanging out in the deep recesses in the corner of her room. I have to protect her. So I'll just be going. And I just really wish that his family would have tried harder and had more of an intervention because, sir. Okay, so moving along. Edward is like mad overprotective in this manner. while also not giving her anything. Okay, so because she gets to this, so she he's very much up here with it, with his obsession. He's up here. You see how I'm off screen? That's where he is. But they're still very much in like the getting to know you, getting to know all about you stage. She doesn't really know that much about him, but she's like divulging her whole like, I like eating this kind of fruit, but I don't really like this kind of vegetable kind of thing, you know? So to her, she doesn't know that he's like head over heels for her. She thinks that, oh, this guy might think I'm kind of interesting. I don't know why, but like, you know, I kind of like him though. So then he gets mad at her when she doesn't understand that he likes her back, because I forget what the conversation even was about, right? She was just like, I just worry that I'm more into you than you are into me. And he is livid. He was like, Bella, you don't know anything. Because she's supposed to know. All right. Anyway, moving on. It is explained in Midnight Sun that they stay the age that they are turned, right? So now Edward is acting every bit of a 17-year-old that you would think, that they're just not thinking things through, not doing things that smartly. Overall, just being an absolute dink. Oh my gosh. He's confusing. And I even felt this myself back then when I was but a girl, 17 years, reading this story. And I thought, I feel like I would be making different choices right now. But back then I was, you know, teenage mindset. It made a bit more sense. Now at my big auntie age, it's like, wow, this is trash, hot, flaming garbage trash that I still love. We get to a point where, you know, the whole baseball thing happens and stuff, and he was like, I'll never leave you, I'll never abandon you, we'll take off and I'll protect you from Victoria, James, and Laurent forever and ever, it's gonna be fine. And she was like, yeah, okay, I believe you. They fight him, they win, boom, bop, bam, we get to New Moon. And they have the birthday party, and she gets a paper cut, and you know, things go terribly from there. And here's where Edward becomes ultimate trash. Oh my god, wait, I almost forgot one of the most important parts that made me close the book and put it down for like 2 weeks. Oh my gosh, okay, back over to Midnight Sun. Bella was crying about something, and he reaches out, grabs her tear on the tip of his finger, licks it, and says, at least I will always have this piece of her in my body for eternity. So if I do, you know, leave her and she goes on without me and, you know, time goes on and stuff, I will always have this piece of her inside me.
They ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine when you're not really fine, but you just can't get into it because they would know.
Anyway, New Moon. Okay, right. So, paper cut. He tries to protect her, whatever. Ultimate trash. Okay, we're back. So, he leads her the next day. It's not the same day, so it's the next day. He leads her to the woods over by her house and breaks up with her in the woods. He was like, no, this isn't gonna work. You're too fragile. You're a liability, and I just don't want to be with you anymore. Goodbye. And then just leaves her in the forest? This is Bella we're talking about. She cannot walk and chew bubblegum on a straight, narrow sidewalk. You're gonna leave her in the forest? Never mind that Victoria and Laurent are still out there somewhere. You're just gonna leave her in the forest? You couldn't have, look, listen, Edward. If you wanted to break up with her because you're just like, it's too dangerous for you to be around us, my world is not for you, fine, whatever, like, you're allowed to break up with somebody. But, like, do it on her front porch. Or, like, her bedroom. In their backyard. In their front yard. Somewhere that's not in the middle of a goddamn forest, you psycho. That Let me tell you all the ways I would have not gotten on that plane to go to Italy. Ooh, buddy. So he breaks up with her, dips off. Boom, we don't see him again until Italy when Alice comes and she was like, Bella, we have to save Edward. He's going to reveal himself to the Volturi. All right. Anyway, so in Italy, we're there. He reveals himself. I swoop him up. Edward proceeds to get his ass beaten by Felix. Now, can we talk about it? Can we talk about it? Edward don't have hands. He don't have hands. Now, I get Edward. Felix. Felix is a big dude. So Edward just wasn't, like, even in his tip top, you're not that guy, buddy. You're not that guy. If I can find the clip to include, baby. Felix threw him up in the air, grabbed him out of the air, chokeslam, slid him under a table, punched down through the table to him back up. I never seen nobody get their ass beat like that before. And in front of your girl. I know he was embarrassed. I know he was, because, baby. Actually, you know, maybe he wasn't embarrassed, because, again, it's Felix. Big dude. So he gets his ass beat, and Aro tells him, hey, so go ahead and change her into a vampire. By a certain date, we're gonna come check and make sure you did that, and then things will be kosher. Otherwise, it's curtains for everybody. Thank you so much for coming. Love seeing you. Give all of our love to Carlisle. We'll see you soon. So now Bella has to become a vampire, right? They go take a vote on it at their house. Everybody votes yes, I want you to be a part of the family, except for Rosaline. And then Edward is sitting there absolutely sulking, talking about, why are you doing this to me? I can't believe you all would betray me and want my girlfriend to be a vampire with us. Don't you know it kills me inside? To which Carlisle was like, hey, yeah, listen, you've already decided you're not going to live without her via that little stunt you just pulled, so I'm not going to lose a son behind this chick. So yeah, we're just going to go ahead and turn into a vampire. Leave that on that. Plus, that's what Bella wants. Can we circle back to that? It's what Bella wants. So Bella has made it crystal clear that she wants to be a vampire. And I am convinced that Bella wants to be a vampire because now that she knows that this world is available to her, who wouldn't go for that? Honestly. Truly. So Edward is this at the end of New Moon or somewhere in Eclipse? I don't know. Somewhere he was like, I don't want you to do this just for me. Which Bella was like, hold on. Wait a minute. This isn't about you, buddy. I want to be a vampire for me. And I respected that. I was like, yeah, girl, do not throw your life away for some dude that left you in the forest. But she just wants to be a vampire because she was like, yeah, this is for me. This is cool. I've always felt out of step, like I didn't belong. I was born to be a vampire. Girl, same. I want to be a vampire too. Hello. He's constantly like making decisions for her, which I don't like really jive with. He doesn't trust her to make her own decisions or what's best for her or like taking her thoughts and wants into accountability. He's always like, I know what's best for you kind of thing. Trash. I feel like you threw all of that into the mix with leaving her in the forest and Edward. You were just a piece of work. Anyway, skip two. We get to Eclipse. He's fighting Victoria and Riley and getting his ass handed to him again. Edward cannot fight. I understand how Bella didn't want him to be down there in the battle because she saw him get mixed up in Italy and she was like, my man cannot fight. So I want him up here with me because I don't want him down there getting beat the hell up again. And then he got beat the hell up anyway. Edward don't got hands. He don't got hands. So you know what? Wouldn't he get mixed up by James too? If it wasn't for the other ones coming? No. He held his own a little bit. He did have the upper hand there for a second. Okay. All right, Edward. You don't really have hands, but you might be able to give a two-piece. You might be able to do that. Yes, the thing about Edward, he's just kind of like a... He's just an emo kid. He's just an emo kid. You know, nothing wrong with emo kids. But he's definitely an emo kid, for sure. He just, Everything sucks. Everything's trash. The sun never comes up. It's eternal night. Everything is all bad. I can't believe this girl loves me. Me, a monster. Someone that doesn't deserve any nice things, any good things to happen to him. All of this must be a dream. It's a complete lie. It's a farce. I swear to God, the moment this girl wakes up, comes to, and realizes the monster that I am, because this is the skin of a killer, Bella. She's going to come to her senses, she's going to leave me, and then I'm going to hurl myself off of the cliff of Volturra and let the Volturi tear me apart once again, because there is no life without Bella. Despite the fact that I don't want her to become an immortal to spend all of her life with me, I'm just going to continue to be this perpetually weird-ass individual. Again, why am I Team Edward? No, I'm Team Emmett. I'm Team Emmett. Yeah, Team Emmett. I did like the way that he proposed to her again in Eclipse, though. I thought it was sweet. I too would have said yes at that point because he just seemed quite genuine. I will give him that. That's one point for Edward. Otherwise, I don't know. He's not a bad guy, you guys. He's just different. He's not perfect. He's not perfect at all. So then, you know, Breaking Dawn comes around. They do their little non-fight. And they live happily ever after, I guess. Ooh-doo-doo. And that wraps that up on that. Let me know what you thought of any of this. Do you agree? Do you disagree? Did you learn anything new about Edward here? Was it straightforward and comprehensive? Because it felt like I was a little discombobulated, because trying to describe Edward is discombobulating. I hope you guys understood what I was trying to give you here. I hope that it came across as clear as crystal that has a little bit of dust in it. Anyway, like and subscribe. Let's chat in the comments down below, and I'll see you next time. Bye.